All Tashan. He's not only going to be have a great talk, but he helped you guys navigate where to park your cars.
Yes.
I recognize him. He was out there. All right. A couple things about him. He's going to talk about designing websites for seniors. He's a Turkish American. He started working in this field in 1978. So some of you may not have even been born then. I was, but so he's got a lot of wisdom and knowledge there. And he said the IBM 360 was his first computer. He said it filled up his room. All right, so let's welcome him.
Thank you. Welcome. Well, this is Sergeant White. He was a sniper in Vietnam, a very sharp shooter, and his skills saved many lives in that era. And then, when he's discharged from the army, he returned back to his hometown and set up a business, and had a very successful business over 40 years. A couple of weeks ago, while he was driving from the office to his home, he was stopped by the state trooper. And he didn't know why he was stopped, because he was doing this same route over and over for over 35 years. And he was very low obedient citizen. Anyway, the trooper approached him and he said he just ran a red light, made a wrong turn. Well, he was not sure because he was doing that every day. Well, when you get old, things change. And one of them is your eye and vision. It goes bad. And he missed that sign. No turn on red. So, welcome to Signore. Seniors, for the high school kids, it's the 12th grade, getting ready for the prom, leaving to the college. For the college students, it's just like leaving the university, end of parties, and going to the business life. For military, it's your one rank higher, so you have to obey their orders. Whatever they say, you have to do. Yes. And for us, for the old people, seniority is wisdom. Well, for the next 18 years, every day, 8,000 baby boomers will be turning 65 plus. So when they start turning 85, what they do is they use the internet. And 85% of the seniors use internet. And when they use daily. They are very, very committed to the internet. And this year, the use of social media among the 65 plus years age group is the biggest age group that are using the social media. The biggest age group increase. No, not only the increase, but the number of people that are using the internet.
On which network?
Twitter, Instagram, Facebook.
On all of them.
All of the social media. So, keeping this in mind, we have to design for seniors. And that means we have to design our future self. Because we'll all be seniors. Well, first we had the desktops, laptops, that was good. Then they diminished the size, made it smaller, go to the pads, and then cell phones, and happily, now they have those small Apple Watches. But our eyes never change. They are still the same. And when we grow old, we have some problems. We have this problem with the sizes, we have the degradation of seeing the color, and we'll come that ambiguous figure at the bottom. So the size will change, it matters, and the new N is now 1.7 N. You have to take that into account. And when we grow old, we have some changes in our lenses, in our eyes. They turn into yellow. So it looks like we will be looking through a yellow filter. Just an example, we look like this. But Actually, they are two different colors. We also have problems in seeing the shades of the different colors. We have problems with the navy blue, brown, and for the pastel colors, we have the same thing. You think they are all different colors, but we see like that. More or less the same color. And one more tip. Never use red on black and in small letters, because we see like that, or we don't see it. So the new color is black and white. Okay, we were talking about the ambiguity. We have those three icons. I'm sure you all know what they mean. But let's start with the far end. That's a floppiness. Well, I was introduced that I came to the market at 78, so floppy disk is this for me, and it's a storage media. I don't know why we use on the computer. Oh, it's the save button, and the funnel is filter, and the other one is menu. You know, that menu button is called something else, which will come. Well, what about this? Well, number sign, or a pound sign, press pound on the cell on phones. Now they say hashtag, three names for one. Well, we know those. That's the rotary phone, and the other one is rabbit ear TV. Well, we seniors know it, but please don't use them. We don't know what it means. So choose your icons and fonts wisely. It is very important. And also use the capabilities of your devices. They have their font size adjustments, color adjustments, and everything. So, they have made a survey among the seniors. And these seniors had a computer desktop at their houses, but they have never used an iPad or tablet or any smartphone. So they gave them a couple of questions and they wanted to see how they are doing on those. So they were confused in the change of the look. So when we were doing the responsive design, we have to be very careful. This is Twitter. One of them is the desktop version, the other one is the mobile version. Exactly the same page, exactly the same time. So when they see this at their home, they understand it very well. But when they see the other one, they were a bit confused. Also, when they... Also, they had a big difficulty in seeing the navigation sign or symbol. They couldn't find it, so what they did is they just click on the biggest picture they see to go to the next one. And that was the biggest mistake. So, let's see this. This was the menu icon, as we see. But we call them hamburger icon for some reason. Well, it looks like a hamburger, but actually it was not a hamburger icon. It was originally designed for Xerox Star computers and actually for the workstation. It was designed by a guy called Norm Cox, and they also made fun of him, and they called him, they called this thing as the air vent. And he uses the air vent to make Windows cool. So seniors decided to click on the menu icon when they see it is a button-like box, something like that. So to sum up, we have to label the icon. That's very, very important. And then we have to make the icons look like a button, so that seniors can click on it. And we have to give enough space around so that we can click on it. You know, we have to recognize what's going on. So it should be bigger, clearer, and better call to action buttons. And don't forget the difference. We were using mouse at home, and now we are using fingers on the mobile devices. And we are, don't forget, we have big fingers and we have shaky ones. So instead of mouse, we have to use fingers and additional space. So when you are designing for seniors, you have to take some very critical points into consideration. First, all the data information that you put should be very short sections. Seniors don't or want or don't or can't read long paragraphs. And give instructions very clearly. Don't write them one by one. Put some numbering or guiding system. We want to follow a link. Just like in the life, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way. We never skip a year in our ages. So try to get away from the technical jargon, technical terms. They look nice for the developers, designers, but seniors, us, we hardly understand them. And we try to click once. And if you don't like it, click many times. So, arrange your designs for single click. When you want somebody to double click, they will click, wait, it doesn't work, then they will click many times. And scrolling, the whole page goes down. We love to scroll on our pads, but we cannot stop because once it goes forever. So, minimize it. As I said earlier, the clickable target should be visible and standing all by itself. It should not be embedded in a picture or alongside. It looks nice on YouTube when you have subscribe here, click, but instead of clicking that button, when I click the video, it stops. And I don't like that. Also, add some features that would help the handicapped or elderly people to use your programs or your websites better, just like text-to-speech or using the Siri function talking to you. And mostly when you have a mobile version, provide the text-only version if they want to use it. Text-only versions are very important at scalable text. Only versions are very, very critical. So there is a site on the government's computers which has a very, very interesting hints and guidelines. These slides will be online so you can get them. And please go there and see what they have tested and what they have suggesting for us. And don't forget, one day we will be all old. And we are designing this website for our future self. So when you think today, think tomorrow. Somebody else sitting in these chairs tomorrow will be designing for you. So we are setting the standards for them. It's not us today, it should be us tomorrow. Earlier in the morning, we were talking about responsive design and how it changed, how it evolved. It used to be one size shrinking, and now we are having different size. So maybe in the future, we will have different websites for different age groups. Maybe young kids will go and watch something else exactly on the same network that you go, or It may be different with the colors. You may be able to choose different color schemes for your eyes. And once you set it all up, it will go all for yourself. Well, I planned this presentation to be short and quick because I know everybody has a very important questions to ask. And you cannot think of all the questions before you have answers. So as I will be wrapping up, I said, design for your future self. These are the types of designers that we meet every month in Orange County. And we, as you see, we will be designing for our future self. So if you want to get hold of me, I'm Cemal Tashan. Oh. Did I say don't put red? And that's and I can be found everywhere at Tashan. If you have anything you want to hear, learn, I'm ready to help. And I think we have enough time to ask some questions, and I'll answer. Please.
Some of the tips where you had a full design system in WordPress, are there plugins for that?
Well, the question is there a plugin?
I was going to say, make sure you repeat.
Sure. Is there a plugin for designing for seniors on WordPress or not? Well, there are some plugins which would change your website's look with the color schemes and so on. But again, earlier this morning, they had a session where you can write the plugin and submit. And maybe that's the other good thing for the plugin developers is develop for the seniors. Well, the question is there a plugin for to read the text aloud? Yes, actually, it's not the plugin, but it's the device itself. Apple devices, Samsung, Android devices, they all read it for you.
Okay, but on the computer?
Well, even the computers have it. Even the computers have it.
Right.
Well, the question is, at the admin part of WordPress, at the dashboard, are there any sections and things to do that? Well, actually, you know WordPress better than me, but...
Seniors better than me.
That's it. Thank you.
You can do Control Plus and everything.
Yes.
But it's... The colors, yeah. I don't know about the color
settings.
Put in WordPress.
Well, it's not only WordPress, but your computers,
yeah.
They have apps that okay. Will change the whole color. And in, I know it's on Windows 8, it's not functioning that well, but in Mac, you can have different color schemes, high contrast, or yeah, just get rid of the pastel colors and put, but that creates another problem for the designers. Because you want to have a perfect look, and then when somebody else overrides your color scheme, it looks ugly.
Yeah.
So it has to be designed at the beginning.
Well,
go ahead.
Well, I have a
Well, the question is, the question is, I have a website using the pre-made themes, and if I can change the font sizes by CSS modifications and so on, well, That's something good, but then you have to modify the width of the tables and things. So that's exactly what I'm... Yeah, but even the size of those columns may change, and that's why I want to have this talk, because they have to design those, thinking the colors and the font sizes will change. And not only on the computers, desktop, laptops, but on the cell phones. I mean, we try to make it maximize, and I try to move right and left. Well, if you get used to that, that's normal. But for that test group, they never did that. They didn't want to punch and pinch and zoom and click. They just wanted to see, and they want to click on the biggest picture, not even an icon, just to go to the next step. This. Okay.
The walls are super small. Well, they're not numbered. So I think we have a long way to go with it.
Well, I have to repeat that for the people watching us. She has been to the USA.gov site, and horrible. It's horrible, and it has nothing that we saw. Well, that's exactly correct. Not only us, the government, and all the big companies. Well, try to go to one of those airline sites and try to find a date that you will be going. It's so hard to do those. Now they are coming with a different method. Some airlines are having the Rolodex type. Well, I don't know if you know Rolodex, but... so you will choose your date instead of clicking on it. So that creates some ease, but it's not the solution. The solution is to start from the scratch, design these in mind. Just design something not to function the way that you like, but it will be also usable. And the seniors that we are talking, the 55 and over, are the big spenders on the internet. They have money, they use credit cards, and they love to travel. So they would love to go to the travel sites, get tickets, and when the site creates problem, they just forget it. And they go to the phone and try to call their travel agent, which we lose customers on our websites, because we want to develop and we want the customers to come to our own websites rather than calling the travel agent. So it's most important thing is think your customer, think the end user, designed for them, and that will work. Well, we have some time. I don't want to leave you early, please.
Yeah, you mentioned earlier in your talk, and you referenced responsive design, and you sort of implied that, you know, we have a model of responsive that you adapt to the site, and you sort of suggest that maybe there's a cultural responsiveness. And my question is, do you think it would be culturally insensitive to provide a pathway specifically for people who are older and kind of call it out in that way, in the way you present it? Because it's a culture problem, right?
Well, the question is, my earlier comment on responsiveness, to change it for the seniors, a different thing, will that be culturally irresponsible? Insensitive? Well, I had a similar talk in Minnesota at the WordCamp, and after that talk, I got a listener coming. He said, "You talk very well, you gave the good things, but what about the colorblind? We cannot see anything, and you haven't mentioned anything there." I said, "Well, I exacted, would it be insensitive to say, click here if you are colorblind, or do this if you are that?" He said, "No. We want to see, we want to understand. So it's an option. If they have the option to choose, maybe you should not call it senior site or elder site, but increase font, change color, have those kind of different labeling. But the need is there, especially for the colorblind. I did a research after that gentleman, and yes, there are some apps, yes, there are some plugins, yes, there are some websites specially designed for that. And for the vision problems or some blind people, they want to hear, they don't want to go to your website. And yes, there are sites for them. And their keyboards are designed accordingly, so they don't need to do anything. They just type in the address, they listen to the news, they watch the sports. It's all audio. So naming or labeling is very important, but it should be there. And I'm not suggesting that all sites look same. I mean, I showed you the Twitter site. It's different in every medium, but you have to tell that this is Twitter. This is just the part of it for this phone or for the tablet that you are using. And we just got rid of the unnecessary parts that we think this is unnecessary for this medium. But if you say, this is this, this is that, it's very hard for the seniors to use your product. Well, I guess we are a bit early. Oh, please.
I'd love to know the names of some of the plugins that are available. You can say they are and they don't show.
Yes. Well, I'll, as they everybody says, I'll be in the happiness bar. I'll try to pull out some, but if not, I'll put them on the Twitter, internet, my website. So there are some very good plugins, which I don't want to miss their names. And they are so good that you just say, change the font size from 1EM to 1.7. So it does everything for you. You don't need to do anything. So they are so good. Well, please.
You mentioned the 1.7 have font. Is that just like the ability to increase the font for certain, or if a person wants it, or do you recommend just from now on just like increasing font sizes in general all across the board?
Well, the question is about that 1.7M. Should it be increasable or it should be the standard? Well, this number came out from that specific test survey. They said, which one do you like? There were bigger ones, smaller ones, and 1.7 was the chosen one. So it was the most used, most liked font size. So that's why I suggested that. And I don't know if it will be a standard or not, but they are changing the font sizes every time. So 1.7 was the chosen one.
Please. To clarify, 1.7 for the seniors or 1.7 for everything?
Well, that survey was made among 55 plus, so it's for them. So, but it looks like 1.7 is good for everybody too. And we don't want to see, because the screens are getting smaller and smaller. And I'm sure you have seen the Apple Watch. Now they are using our black and white colors, and when you have the option to change the color scheme is very limited. So they are in the correct way, I would guess. Well, you have a question, Sarah?
Yeah.
Okay. Well then, thank you so much. Well, as I said, I'll be at the happiness bar, and then you can get everything else on my website. Thank you so much.